what the Yoga for Trauma Recovery class normally looks like. So this class is typically for women only or women identified individuals, and specifically we target regulating the nervous system, bringing relaxation response is what it's called, to the body and the mind through a couple different yoga techniques. So a lot of people, when you think of yoga, you think of just the movement portion, but we also incorporate some gentle breath work and guided meditations that are short to help kind of bring all of these relaxation feelings into your body and your mind. Everything I ever teach is optional, so I always tell people showing up is like 99% of the work, and if you do anything extra, it's just extra credit. So don't worry if you have no yoga experience at all. If you're very experienced in yoga, I welcome you as well. This is really a great opportunity for self-exploration and self-regulation. So I hope some of this comes to you as something useful and new, and it might inspire you to register for the course, because it is something that I really enjoy teaching as a yoga teacher and just personally as the spouse and caregiver of a combat Army veteran who suffers from PTSD. So I have a lot of personal and professional experience with this. Nothing you can say or do in class will shock me or worry me, so please always ask me questions. Let me know ahead of time if there's something specific that you're worried about or interested in, and I'd be happy to talk to you beforehand. We are going to start on our backs, on our mats. So please lower yourself onto your mat with your knees bent and your feet flat on the floor. And how I like to rest is in constructive rest pose, which just means you keep your knees bent and take your feet as far away from each other as your mat, and then let your knees come into the center towards each other. Now relax your hands either on the floor or on your belly. Try to roll your shoulders down and away from your ears and look straight ahead at something on the ceiling, or you could always close your eyes or just lower your eyes if it's a little too bright up there. And bring all of your attention to the parts of your body that are touching the floor. It's nothing magical, right? You're just bringing your awareness kind of away from everything outside of you and everything you've been doing and thinking about today. Try to pay attention just to the parts of your body that are in contact with the surface behind you. And it's normal while you're doing this for your brain to get distracted and start to think about things. So whenever you notice that happening, try not to give yourself a hard time. Just bring your attention back over and over. And now move your attention to the parts of your body that are moving as you breathe. Continue to bring your attention to your belly and your chest. Watch and observe the feelings as they rise and fall just with your natural breath. You don't have to change your breathing. And then bring your attention to your inner resource. So if you've never taken a class with me before, your inner resource is a sanctuary in your mind. It's, some people call it a happy place, but it really could be anything. It could be a memory, it could be a fantasy, just something that makes you feel safe and calm and secure. And try to use all of your senses now as you see your inner resource in your mind's eye. What do you see there? What do you hear? you can grab the sides of your pants and pull your leg back while you keep your shoulders and hips on the ground. Start to roll your left ankle. Go one direction a few times. Keep breathing. Switch your grip so that your hands are behind your thigh, and then start to lift your leg straight so your toes are towards the ceiling. Now, if this is uncomfortable or maybe it's particularly strenuous for you, you can use a strap instead. Put the strap or a scarf or a belt, whatever you have, underneath your left foot, and then hold on to the strap so you can send your foot up to the sky this way. Wherever you are, take a deep breath. And exhale, check in with the feelings in the back of your leg. If your leg is shaking or burning, that's normal. You don't want anything sharp or intense though, so if it's painful, bend your knee a little more. Take another deep breath here, just noticing. Take another breath here. Notice how it feels to breathe as you're twisting through the torso. And then release. Bring your head back to center first, then roll yourself back onto your back. Let your left leg go long. And observe any of that leftover feeling. Sometimes the greatest part of a pose is when you come out of the pose, because you might have a leftover feeling of relaxation, tingling. Maybe there's some blood flow that you're noticing. This is all normal. So observe whatever feelings are still happening in your left leg. Good. And then we'll do the other side. So bring your right leg back for a hug. Wrap your fingers around your knee or grab onto your pants. And start to roll your ankle on this side. Go a few times one direction, noticing your muscles and your feet and your calf. And then pause and go the other direction. Your shoulders down, keep breathing. And then start to extend your leg up to the sky. Maybe using your hands behind your thigh. Maybe you use your strap here. And humans are funny, we like symmetry, so we tend to try to force the two sides to be exactly the same. But really, that's not realistic because we have injuries and scar tissue, and we have different bone structure actually on both sides of the body. So allow this leg to be as straight as this leg wants to be. Don't force it to be the same as the other side. Keep working your heel up towards the ceiling and bend your knee as much as you need. Bend it again, take a little break. Keep experimenting here with a calm breath. Good. Release your strap. bring your arms up overhead. On your exhale, bring your right hand down to the floor, reach up higher, and then over to the right. Stay here for a breath. You can look up or down. And then inhale through the center, reach up with both hands. Exhale, the left arm comes down. Inhale, reach up higher, and then over towards the left. Big breath on this side. Inhale to center, reach up with both hands. Exhale, bring your fingertips to the floor and start to walk yourself forward over your legs. Let your head and neck be heavy. Big deep breath. And again. Look forward at your hands. Gently start to walk your fingers back towards your body so that you're sitting tall again. And now bring your attention once again to the parts of your body that are touching the floor. Notice how that feels a little different now that you're in a sitting position. And bring your attention again to all the parts of you that are moving as you're breathing. Notice if your breath might feel a little different. And at the beginning of class, that's normal for your breath to feel a little slower, maybe a little longer. And now bring your hands to your heart, either together in a prayer position with your thumbs touching your heart, or you can stack your hands one on top of the other. It doesn't matter to me what you choose. And look down or bow down towards your hands. This motion is in gratitude of yourself. So give yourself a sincere thank you just for showing up today. And accept my sincere gratitude for each and every single one of you. Thank you so much for tuning in and supporting Sheldon Community Center and for supporting yourselves. It's so hard to do, and I appreciate that. Remember that you have a body, but you are not just your body. You have a mind, but you are not just your thoughts. And you have emotions, but you are not just your feelings. My name is Alexandra. I hope to see you all in class.